The match. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to coverage of Grand Prix Dallas. I'm Gabby Sparks, joined today by Luis Scott Vargas, and we're heading into round one. Here we see Sam Clayton. He's going to be playing Banned Spirits today, and he's going to be facing off against Matt Mendoza, who's brought Red Green Land Destruction to the table.
I noticed you didn't say joined willingly by Luis Scott Vargas.
All right. You get a medal. All right, so our players are about to kick things off, and can you give us just a rundown of what you expect to happen in this matchup?
So the Banned Spirit deck is definitely the more aggressive deck in this matchup. It actually looks a little bit like what you'd imagine a Collected Company deck might look like in Modern, with a lot of the same spirits that saw some play in Standard, as well as Geist of St. Traff. That's a very powerful card. And then four copies of Collected Company. So the Spirits deck's trying to pressure the opponent and use Spell Queller and Mausoleum Wanderer in order to stop them from, you know, utilizing their game plan before you end up winning.
So here we see Matt Mendoza kicking things off with an Utopia Sprawl. And so he's going to try to get off the races here quickly. Do you think that Banned Spirits has the correct tools to be able to combat things like land destruction?
The Banned Spirits deck has a pretty low curve and a lot of instants. So I would imagine that land destruction is not quite as effective against it. Also, Mausoleum Wanderer can sack to make Matt pay more for an instant or sorcery. And that does a pretty good job of countering things like Molten Rain or Stone Rain.
So Sam with a Mausoleum Wanderer, no turn two play. However, this deck does play a lot of instant speed spirits. So
yeah, so something like a Rattle Chains means that Sam would be able to, continue curving out and then maybe go one drop, two drop, three drop out of kind of like an aggressive deck is pretty good. It's, even though the spirits deck isn't quite as aggressive as like a burn deck,
It
still can pressure the opponent.
So with a land destruction deck, Luis, I think one of the questions that people might find interesting is, how do you actually win with a stack if you didn't actually manage to do the land destruction thing, right?
It's got some big threats. It's got the Platinum Empyreans that we mentioned earlier, and then Storm Breath Dragon and Chandra Torch of Defiance are both fairly substantial threats.
All right, so it looks like Sam cracking the Windswept Heath, getting a Hallowed Fountain, and in comes Rattle Chains. Looks like Matt going to be cracking that Windswept Heath also. Let's see if he has a response.
Whenever my opponent fetches Forest, on a board like this when they could have just gotten a tap duel, I start thinking Blood Moon. And the red-green deck is for sure playing Blood Moon. In fact, four copies
four
of
copies
it.
In the main deck. All right, so that might be an indication for Sam also to be a little bit more careful with the lands that he chooses to fetch in the next couple of turns. Matt still... All right, so tapping three for Beast Within, targeting Hallowed Fountain. Let's see if Sam wants to do anything about that.
And he can let it go and get a 3-3. He could also counter it with a Mausoleum Wanderer. One of the big reasons to counter it is that Sam has two copies of Geist of St. Traft in his hand.
All right, so it does look. Mausoleum Wanderer. Yeah, going to be taking one for the team. Countering that Beast Within, Matt says, okay.
I love this matchup because both players are reading the cards of the opponent.
Because
Utopia Sprawl and Mausoleum Wanderer, like, they are definitely cards that get played in Modern, but they're not cards that get commonly
These
played
just
in Modern.
The most, you don't expect to go into a match and play against Red Green Land Destruction. Like, that's not a very popular deck. It's not popular online. It's sweet.
Yeah.
It's definitely sweet.
And Modern's a huge format. You know, you've got something like, 13 years worth of cards that are legal now. So, and getting to know every single deck is can be a challenge, especially when this Banned Spirits deck, for example, is fairly new. It's basically come into being in the last couple months. So it is pretty funny that the players are both playing utilizing some cards you don't see every day.
That's what I like about Modern. Actually, is sometimes you play against these decks that are two or three piece card combos, and they're so sweet when they actually work out. Maybe they're not extremely popular, but They are a pleasure to play against. So it looks like Sam deciding to play this Geist of St. Traft here. And another reason to want to have countered that Beastful then is he has a Collected Company in hand.
Yeah, and being able to curve into Company on four is pretty good.
Interesting. So he chose not to play that Geist of St. Traft.
Yeah, he was about to play it and then decided to utilize Rattle Chains, which gives all the spirits flash. But the Geist Rattle Chains combo is not one that comes up very often, but you might as well take advantage of it.
All right, so it looks like an Arbor Elf hitting the board for Matt. Sam says, okay. Another land. We're going to see a pass back, and here you come. The not often seen Geist of St. Traft with Flash.
Arbor Elf is a cool combo, too. It can untap Utopia Sprawled Forests, so it taps for additional mana. We saw a pretty exciting Bonfire of the Damned last time we saw this deck on camera, and... You know that we're getting set up for Bonfire right here. If Matt draws one of his four copies of Bonfire, then he will roast all of those spirits. In fact, if Dina just has it in hand with the Arbor Elf, he'll be able to play it.
All right, so Geist of St. Traft and Rattle Chase getting in. Geist triggers. Sam gets a 4/4 Angel, and he still has that Collected Company in hand. So things looking pretty good over here for Sam. What are you trying to do if you're Matt? You're facing a pretty. You're taking a lot of damage in this attack.
Hopefully finding Bonfire. That'd be step one. Otherwise, actually, a Platinum Empyrean, like Madcap Experiment into Platinum Empyrean, is actually very effective against the Spirits deck. They have four copies of Path to Exile, but if they don't draw Path or they're one Reflector Mage, then Platinum Empyrean will just sit and play and make sure that Sam can't damage Matt anymore.
This is a different version of a red-green land destruction deck that we saw last time, right? How are these usually built?
The newest addition is the Madcap Experiment. It takes six slots to play the four experiments and the two Platinum Empyreans.
Yeah.
And then a couple of copies of Chandra. So those have replaced some of the earlier threats and I think cut down on the total number of land destruction spells. You see only like two Molten Rains, for example, and three Beast Withins instead of the four of each that we may have seen earlier. Ooh, I see a Bonfire in Matt's hand.
So he has to be careful here because he wants to make sure that if he does want to cast his Bonfire, he might need that Arbor Elf to untap Utopia Sprawl.
Yeah, that would get an additional point on the Bonfire. Though one of the advantages for Sam is that he's got Collected Company, so even if his whole board gets Bonfired here, he can refill with Company end of turn.
All right, so he's chosen to put the Arbor Elf in front of the Geist of St. Traft. He's going to be taking six damage. This drops him down to 10. Another Utopia Sprawl.
And Stormbreath Dragon is a potential play here because it's a great blocker, but it seems very risky to not cast Bonfire.
Yeah, so he is going to go ahead with a Bonfire, but the fact that Sam has a Collected Company...
That can certainly mitigate the damage, and because Bonfire costs XX, it's currently 5 mana... on the stack, so Spellcaller wouldn't actually be able to counter it.
Mm-hmm.
Though Spellcaller is a very effective card in Modern in general because spells tend to be cheap enough. It's very difficult to find spells you can't Spellcaller.
And so here Sam will get an opportunity to refuel his board. But Geist of St. Traft and Rattle Chains do hit the bin.
Oh, someone points out Inferno Titan. That was the card they cut. They used to have Inferno Titan as a finisher, and then Madcap Experiment is the new Inferno Titan.
Gotcha. So Sam fetching up a Temple Garden. And let's see what he can find off of this Collected Company.
Your stomach always sinks when they fetch an untapped Shockland at the end of their
yeah.
turn for the fourth mana.
Yep.
Spirit's deck has... Looks like over 25 hits about... And so that means that Sam's going to be in pretty good shape here if he can hit two things. And he's actually... he almost had the full six, but he actually has an option to play four different spirits here. Not the really high-impact ones he was hoping for. Geist of St. Traft would have been excellent, as well as a Drog Skull Captain. It's a 2/2 that gives your other spirits +1/+1 in Hexproof. But even hitting these two, Selfless Spirit and Rattle Chains, means that he's got more pressure on the board and... You know, just more ways to threaten Matt, especially if you can follow it up with that Drog Skull Captain in hand.
Yeah, all right. So with Matt being a 10 and these two chipping away for four at a time, things are looking pretty good. A second Bonfire would be just completely devastating, though. Oh, well, he has drawn a path to exile now. Ooh, yeah, and so Drogsol Captain.
Yeah, so the path means that he's safe, that Sam is safe from a potential madcap experiment. And the addition of Selfless Spirit to his board does a pretty good job of combating Bonfire. He would still be able to fly over in the air for five.
Yeah. Now with the Drogskull Captain, otherwise he just ends up with like a 2-1 Rattle Chains, right?
Yeah, the Drogskull Captain is a pretty big addition. And that's one of the reasons that this deck gets an additional punch in Modern. So even a Stormbreath Dragon with protection from White's not going
to
do it.
Exactly. And Matt picks up his cards, and they're going to go to game two. So Sam Clayton taking the first game here with Banned Spirits. Now, Luis, what do you think happens once these decks goes post-board?
So the Banned Spirits deck actually, unsurprisingly, does not have a lot in its sideboard dedicated to the red-green land destruction deck. I'm actually...
What a shocker.
Yeah. I'm looking through the sideboard here, and I'm not finding a whole lot that looks incredibly appealing, though. I like the Steel of the Godhead. That's a +2/+2 unblockable enchantment. Basically, it's a way to continue pressuring, and it gives lifelink if it's a white-blue creature.
Mm-hmm.
The red-green deck can board in Sudden Shock and Anger of the Gods, which are a pretty good way to fight a deck full of 2/2s and 2/1s. And even though the Selfless Spirit is annoying against Bonfire, Sudden Shocking a Selfless Spirit and then following up with a Bonfire or Anger is a pretty good play.
You also have the Bonfires, too, so eventually you can dwindle down through the Selfless Spirits and hope to get... Because most of the creatures will die without the Selfless Spirit out, so that seems pretty good. So who do you think becomes better post-board?
I think that Matt Mendoza with the Land Destruction deck gets more out of this, but that's partially because his deck is not as well-suited in Game 1. Whereas Sam doesn't need to change that much. I think his Game 1 configuration is pretty good already. One point of danger for Sam is that he didn't see any creatures besides Arbor Elf, and the red-green deck traditionally plays Stormbreath Dragon, so... Sam could be in danger of potentially siding out Past Exile, and if he does...
Oh, and then he has to deal with a Platinum. No, right. No ways to deal with a Platinum Imperium.
But it looks like he's dodged that.
Okay.
He's actually siding in Quasali Pride Mage, which kills Blood Moon, kills Utopia Sprawl, and kills Platinum Imperium. So that's actually a fairly effective sideboard card.
What do you think of a deck like Banned Spirits for this weekend?
I'm a little wary of playing a deck that... You know, it's kind of like a mid-range deck and gets on. It doesn't get on the board quite as quickly when you're playing against cards like Death Shadow, Glistener Elf, Wild Mikado. I do think Banned Spirits, if it can survive till the mid-game, is very powerful. The combination of Collected Company, Spellcaller, and Geist of St. Traft does a really good job pressuring the opponent and defending yourself from whatever they're doing. I just am worried about getting to the point where you can have mana untapped in a Spellcaller.
Coming into this GP, I was playing a lot of Modern, and I feel like every game was, oh, it's Infect.
Yeah.
I'm dead in a couple turns. Oh, wait, it's that Shadow Aggro. Yeah, I'm dead in a couple turns. Or I was playing one of the two decks.
Well, at least when you're playing against Death Shadow, they're almost dead, too. but you're the one who ends up...
Is that supposed to make you feel better?
No, just more an observation.
When is that zero, Luis?
Yes. Another deck that I'm kind of excited to see this weekend is the Kiln Fiend aggro deck.
Okay.
The blue-red deck using Kiln Fiend, Thing in the Ice, Monastery Swift Spear, and then a bunch of spells like Mutagenic Growth, Teemer Battle Rage, Serum Visions, Lightning Bolt. So it'll be interesting to see what shows up, because these two decks that we're watching are not the fastest decks in Modern.
Right.
I think that leads to a very interesting match, so I like this matchup. But we'll see what happens once the really fast linear decks start rolling in.
Yeah, the Kiln Fiend combo deck is, I don't know if you can call it combo deck, aggro deck, whatever you want to call it. It's pretty cool because it plays similarly to Death Shadow aggro, except you're not actually, your life total being low doesn't actually help you in any way. So you're just kind of living on the edge with that deck. It's a pretty new inclusion. It's been making its rounds around Magic Online. We'll see how popular it is in paper here today, but it's been very popular online.
I like the choice of red sleeves for the red-green land destruction deck.
I'm going to send a message.
Yeah.
So it looks like our players are almost shuffled up. We're heading into game two here. Sam Clayton leads. On the back of that Drogskull Captain and a couple of spirits. Taking down that game. All right, so let's see. It's a couple spell quellers, a couple lands. So he's got a pretty slow hand. It's all threes and a...
Sam's hand is literally a hand from Last Standard.
Yes, it is.
Two spell colors, Reflector Mage Company, three lands. That's my concern. Without something like a Noble Hierarch, like this hand, I mean, you're playing against a deck that is not the fastest, so Sam does have that going for him. But you just most modern decks, if you don't get on the board till turn three, the game has passed you by.
The concern too is if you know Matt's on the play, if they ramp Beast Within and then you're like stuck with a bunch of threes in your hand, like what do you do? I mean, you lose.
You attack obviously. With your 3/3 beast token.
I guess, sure. See, there you go. That's the kind of stuff I'm talking about. Birds of Paradise format.
What Sam does have going for him is he can play Flooded Strand on turn one, and if he does that, then he's able to potentially dodge a Stone Rain for a turn. He has incentive to play Temple Garden because he doesn't want to pay two life later, but playing Flooded Strand turn one does mitigate a turn two land destruction spell. So, Matt didn't have the 3-drop on turn 2, but he's going to have 6 mana on turn 3. So, he's going to be able to drop a turn 3 Stormbreath Dragon before Sam has even played his third land.
Yeah, and this game is quickly slipping away for Sam. Stomping Ground tapped for Matt. And so much mana available next turn.
And if this game was going to slip away from Sam, it would be quickly because his hand, again, powerful, but takes a while to get going. It's a perfect hand that if he had a Noble Hierarch, he would be happy with it. But
how many dorks is this deck playing? 4 Arbor Elf, 4 Utopias for All, 2 Birds of Paradise? Yeah, they can ramp up pretty quickly.
Yeah, and you're playing as a deck with 10 one-drop accelerants, and you're on the draw. Matt potentially worried about a counterspell here.
So it looks like he is going for 4. Thrun the Last Troll.
Yeah, and Thrun is exactly the play here because Matt doesn't know that Sam doesn't have something like Mana Leak or Remand in hand, and by playing Thrun, he's able to avoid that. Thrun can't be countered. So that's just one of many reasons to like and want to emulate Thrun. Arbro pulling doing second duty here and bashing in for one.
Yeah.
Also interesting to see that the Bant Spirits deck, because it's 3 colors and it only has 1 of each basic, it's going to be hard for it to adapt to Blood Moon, but Matt may have sided out Blood Moons or some other land destruction components. So he might be just playing more of like a mid-range red-green deck that just tries to play 4 and 5 drops and bonfires, which is something is a configuration that his deck's capable of.
All right, so we're going to see an untap from Sam. See what he can string together here. Facing this Thrun and a couple of Arbor Elves. Looks like he's drawn a Geist of St. Trap for the turn.
The good thing for Sam is that he can outrace a Thrun fairly easily. The problem is he's going to have trouble outracing Stormbreath Dragon, and Spellcaller can't counter Stormbreath Dragon. So if Sam leaves mana up for Spellcaller and then Matt just plays the Stormbreath Dragon in hand, Sam's going to end up in a lot of trouble.
No, he just loses at that point if that happens.
Yeah,
right?
He just takes 8, and then next turn Stormbreath actually can threaten to Monstrous. Haven't seen a monstrous Stormbreath Dragon in quite
some
time.
So Geist of St. Trap coming down for Sam, and a very good creature on offense, and not so much on defense.
Ooh, I see Matt with a Beta Stone Rain in hand. I like it.
Like the style? How much do you think the land destruction decks, how often do they just board out of the land destruction plan and just try to go for a more mid-range plan?
I would say... You know, more often than you might think, just because with 4 Kitchen Finks and 2 Thruns in the sideboard and a Chameleon Colossus, Matt has the cards in order to take out land destruction. And in a playing against a deck that has a really low curve, the land destruction is just not that effective.
Sure. All right, so it looks like Bonfire coming down.
And Matt, by playing this Bonfire here, indicates that even though he could have Stormbreathed, he's a lot more worried about Geist getting out of control.
All right, so Sam just playing a forest and is going to pass. We do know he has a Collected Company in hand.
Yeah. And so if Matt leads with Storm Breath here, Sam doesn't really have incentive to company in response because, again, Spellcaller doesn't counter it. But when Matt attacks, Sam can company. The problem is it's really hard to beat Storm Breath Dragon in the air without using white creatures. Since Drogskull Captain and Selfless Spirit are, and Spellcaller are all white, and Storm Breath has protection from white.
Yeah.
So what Sam would need is like two Mausoleum Wanderers and like a Drogskull Captain or something.
It doesn't. Yeah, it definitely doesn't seem like blocking Storm Breath Dragon is going to be feasible in this game. All right, so counting up to five, and there's Storm Breath Dragon hitting the battlefield. It's been a long time since we've seen one of those. Looking very good on this board, though. And against this deck. So it looks like that Storm Breath Dragon has resolved. All right. Going into attacks and throwing in the Storm Breath, getting in. See what Sam wants to do about this.
And this isn't quite lethal, but casting company now does give Sam the most options.
So it looks like a Drogskull Captain, a couple of Geist of St. Traft, a Kuzali Pride Mage was a find as well, a Selfless Spirit too.
I mean, these are some good hits. It's just because Thrawn regenerates and because Storm Breath has protection from white, Sam still just doesn't have great blocks here.
So it looks like Sam is opting for the Drogskull Captain and the Geist of St. Traft.
Geist of St. Traft has double hexproof thanks to Drogskull Captain.
All right, so he is going to take all the damage and go to four. And he has a second company in hand. Still no way to block that Stormbreath Dragon, though.
The funny thing is Sam's actually like creeping close to lethal if he has like another Drogskull Captain. It's not going to be enough, but the Spirit's deck can do a lot of damage out of nowhere.
All right, so he's going to company main phase. Looks like a Queller, a Rattle Chains, another Geist. Yep, and he's going to pick up his cards. And we're going to see a game three here between Sam Clayton and Matt Mendoza. Matt's start was blisteringly fast, going Birds of Paradise into Arbor Elf, and that was just not enough for Sam to come back.
Yeah, and then the Thrun into Storm Breath, mid-range at its finest. We have yet to see a single land get destroyed, which I'm kind of disappointed
by. It does look like he might have sided out of a lot of the land destruction components in the matchup.
Matt did try to beast within a land in game one, but Sam had the Mausoleum Wanderer to counter that, so that did not quite work out.
Looks like Sam is bringing a couple of Phantasmal Images.
That used to be a great answer to Thrun when a Phantasmal Image made them killed the Thrun because of the legend rule.
Mm-hmm.
The new legend rule, well, new as in 5 years ago now,
yeah.
Does mitigate that, but Phantasmal Image is still an answer to Storm Breath Dragon because you end up with a 4-4 flying Storm Breath that, even though it dies if it's targeted, Matt does not have a lot of ways to target it.
Seems like it's also basically the only way he can deal with Storm Breath Dragon too.
Yeah, just Path to Exile not going to do it. Spellcaller not going to do it. Reflector Mage not going to do it.
I wonder if this might make him board out Path to Exiles, seeing all those. Doesn't really do anything against Thrun. Doesn't really do anything against Storm Breath.
Yeah, if you can't kill Thrun or Storm Breath, pathing an Arbor Elf for a bird is kind of futile at best.
Defeats the purpose.
And Sam still hasn't seen Madcap Experiment or Platinum Empyrean, so I really could see Path coming out here. One thing Sam might be worried about is Inferno Titan, because the red-green deck traditionally does play that.
Yeah.
But because the red-green deck is not a very commonly played deck, I don't know how much Sam is worried about a card he hasn't seen before.
I was going to say, I don't think people will sit in front of the land destruction deck and say, like, well, the last time I saw one of these decklists online, they were definitely playing all these.
Yeah. Blessed Alliance is actually an interesting way to deal with both Thrun and Storm Breath Dragon. So I could see those coming in. And it looks like Sam has those selected.
Oh, it looks like those Phantasmal Images are not actually going to make the main deck. Yeah, they are not. Some Blessed Alliances are what are going to come in. line seems like it could be pretty good, as long as no Arbor Elves or...
Well, it depends. How much do you want to gain for life?
I want to kill Stormbird is what I want to do.
And we didn't see Matt attacking with a lot of Arbor Elves last game anyway, because most of the time Sam's going to have a 2-2 out. So, yeah, Blessed Alliance, I think, is going to do the trick here.
Is that something that Matt, you think you should be careful about, just like sending in an Arbor Elf if...
It depends on the situation. Certainly, if he's got excess Arbor Elves and his Storm Breath would be lethal, That sounds like a good way, because Blessed Alliance is becoming a more played card. It's got a lot of different flexible modes. The fact that you can gain life or kill an attacking creature or make them sacrifice an attacking creature is pretty big in Modern, and it's fairly cheap. So it's a card to be aware of, certainly.
I've definitely seen it in the sideboards of a lot of Modern decks recently, and it's especially nice because you can sometimes kill their Death Shadow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can, target them to gain life.
Yeah, target them to gain life,
exactly.
And then it kills their shadows. I mean, assuming that their life total is not too low at this point, but you can really get Death Shadow aggro players with it.
My favorite is casting Condemn on their Death Shadow and killing their other Death Shadow.
Oh, that's sick. All right, so Matt's drawn his hand. It looks like a couple of lands of Stormwith Dragon. Oh, it's a lot of lands, actually.
Sam is exactly what he's looking for, Noble Hierarch. That is the most important card to have in your opening hand in this deck by a lot.
Yeah, and a Drogskull Captain. A Beast Within. So it's a lot of lanes of Beast Within and a Stormbreath Dragon for Matt.
Yeah, it looks like an Anger of the Gods lurking in between those foothills. And that anger is really what gives Matt pause here. If it was 5-land Beast Within Stormbreath Dragon, I think that he would be much more inclined to just mulligan it.
Yeah.
Anger on turn 3 can be quite effective against spirits if they don't have a Spellcaller or Selfless Spirit, but Mausoleum Wonder also throws a wrench into that plan, so Matt may be inclined to mulligan.
Yeah, he decided to mulligan it. What do you think you would have done with that hand?
I think mulliganing it was good. Basically, not having an accelerant and then pinning all your hopes and dreams on this anger,
which
gets answered by at least 10 cards in the opposing deck, that just seems risky.
Seems reasonable. On the other hand, Sam has chosen to keep. Because he has a pretty quick start with mana acceleration and a couple of threes, so getting on the board quickly. Geist of St. Traft unanswered finishes the game very fast. All right, so let's see what Matt can find on this six.
And a lot of these matches are going to come down to who can play a turn one accelerant. Well, Matt has the turn one accelerant at the Arbor Elf, but he's only got a one land hand. And there's one land as a forest. It doesn't provide red. All the rest of his spells are red except that Thrun.
Yeah, this is a tough one.
Being
a double red card in hand too.
Yeah, I would be very tempted to keep this, but I think mulliganing it is certainly the safer choice. Basically, if you need to draw, you have forest and Arbor Elf. You have 2 mana. You need to draw 2 lands in like the next 4 cards, which that's not unreasonable to ask for.
You
but
do get a scry.
But you are certainly not a favorite to get there. And if you fall behind in against the Spirits deck, it can be really tough. The Spirits deck is built to punish decks that fall behind.
Yeah. There's a lot of redundancy in its cards.
Sudden Shock helps, though. Sudden Shock means that you do get to, if you draw a single red, buy yourself a little bit of time. But Matt's looking at that hand and wondering, like, am I going to face down an early Geist of St. Traft and just sit there on Forest Arbor Elf?
And he has chosen to mulligan it. Going with a safer route. Damn, that was a tough keep. Keeper Mole.
Yeah. We'll have Keeper Moles for you later, though. That hand does not feature.
Yeah. We have more popular decks in Modern, not Red Green Land Destruction. You don't get to see that one that often. All right. So Matt Mendoza going down to 5. Oh, no. This hand is... Oh, wait. He does have a Bird of Paradise. He has a Bird of Paradise.
Yeah.
And he's created a land to the top. All right. He can definitely work with this.
Yeah. This is basically the same hand as last time, but Birds is much better than Arbor Elves in this opener. And once you're at 5 cards, you certainly have to keep this hand.
Yeah. I thought he had Forest and no turn 1 accelerant. All right. So here we go. Birds of Paradise and a Forest for Matt Mendoza. We're going to see a pass back to Sam. We do know that he has at least 1-3 in hand, so he is going to have that very quick Geist of St. Traff, presumably.
Deciding whether he wants to fetch or just play his basic planes here.
Oh, he is just going to... Oh, he must have a Spell Queller.
He does have a Spell Queller, and he's hoping that Matt just runs a spell into it. But, you know, when your opponent mulls to five, they are less likely to have a spell at the ready.
It looks like he might be split-seconding.
I think Matt, yeah, is deciding whether he wants to just take out that Noble right now. The thing is, even though Split Second can't be responded to, Sam can still tap the Noble for mana, so he will still be able to play a Spell Caller, just not in response to the Sudden Shock.
All right, so that Split Second does take care of the Noble Hierarch, and we're going to see the turn back to Sam.
You know, the Spell Caller turn's still not going to work out. Matt played a Split Second card on the first time, and he's going to play a Thrun. Oh, actually, Thrun does get Spell Callered. Spell Caller exiles the spell. It doesn't counter it.
Oh, okay. So Stomping Ground coming down. Four. Here comes Thrun. And Sam cracking. So it looks like it might work out. All right. So, and he is being careful about the lands that he's fetching. It looks like he's definitely keeping Blood Moon at the forefront of his mind.
Yeah, fetching out the basic island there, playing the plains. But, oh, man, the fact that Spell Caller gets Thrun is just such a brutal interaction for Matt here.
double verifying, double triple check.
Sam,
it looks like they're talking to the head. Yeah, they're talking to a judge, a table judge.
Just checking that this does in fact spell disaster for Matt.
And here it comes, Spell Queller. Eating that Thrun, it tastes bad.
Oh man.
Wow, so we're going to see a pass back, and Sam has drawn a Drug Skull Captain for this turn.
Look, as someone whose sympathies lie with Thrun, I'm not pleased by this turn.
I'm sure. Drug Skull Captain helping that Spellcaller Nugget for a little bit more.
And now even a Bonfire for two is not going to do it, but Matt has the perfect answer here. And he's playing an untapped land to play around Spell Pierce, and he gets to play Anger of the Gods.
So Anger of the Gods coming down. This Birds of Paradise is going to die too, but away go all of Sam's spirits, and back comes Thrun to the battlefield.
Yeah, the bird does
the
die.
The bird is dead.
Exiled, even.
I'm sure they will fix that momentarily, but yeah, this bird is not was not long for this world. He did his job.
Yeah, the bird did quite a good job here, And remember, Matt Mulligan to five this game.
Yeah.
And so far, things have played out very nicely for him.
There it is. Matt also with a Chandra in hand. And Sam doesn't really have any way to pressure that Chandra either. So it looks like Matt is digging himself out of this Mulligan to five.
Yeah. Sam has what looks like another Drog School Captain as backup. But... a Drog Skull Captain by itself is just not going to fight against a Thrun or a Chandra very effectively.
Mm-hmm. And he's just drawn a land for the turn. So Flooded Strand coming down for Sam. There's a Drog Skull Captain, and that's the last spell left in Sam's hand. And Matt can really start clocking Sam at this point. There you go, Chandra. Torch of Defiance coming down, targeting the Drog Skull Captain. And now Sam has no board and no cards in hand. Looks like this might be a quick one. And Matt sequences spells in a nice way here. It seems like he's really giving himself a good... He got a lot of value out of this Anger of the Gods.
Yeah, things worked out very nicely for him. So even though Thrun did get Spell Clored, which I still maintain is an egregious violation of everything Thrun stands for, the fact that it hit under the Spell Clored and then Anger of the Gods wiped everything out... meant that at the end of the day, Matt's the one with a bunch of threats left standing.
All right, Sam.
Sam needs a big top deck. He needs a collected company is what he needs.
Yeah. And it's a Spell Queller.
Well, Spell Queller can fly over and kill Chandra because Sam's going to get hit down to 7 off the Thrun. The Chandra presumably pluses and flips a card so Matt gets to see another card, but it's not over yet.
It's another land. Matt has drawn a land for this turn. So he's going to choose not to play that, but that does hit Sam for a couple points. This is where these spirit decks struggle. They're so bad at playing from behind.
Yeah, and that Spell Queller is going to get to eat the Chandra, so Sam really needs to find a big creature here.
Path to Exile is a draw for Sam. Cavern of Souls naming spirits. And Sam has chosen not to attack the Chandra this turn.
Ultimately, I think it's going to be irrelevant because Matt picked up a Stormbreath Dragon.
Yeah, and he's also revealed a Beast Within from the Chandra as well. But I think at this point he's just choosing to target Sam with Burn. Here's Stormbreath Dragon. Spellcaller can't block it. Path to Exile can't kill it. And there's a handshake. Matt Mendoza moves on. He's 1-0 here at GP Dallas.
Yeah, nice comeback from a mulligan to 5 there for Matt Mendoza. And we didn't see a single land being destroyed. Though I guess Sunshock and a Noble Hierarch kind of counts as land destruction. So I guess we'll allow it just to make sure that the red-green land destruction gets like a little bit of credit.